Hello friends, in this video we are going to study the various combinations of atomic orbitals. Now in the last video also we have studied the combinations of atomic orbitals, but that was by using the PowerPoint presentation. But for more understanding, I am preparing the video by using paper and the pen. So let us start with the various combinations of atomic orbitals. So as we have seen, there are various types of combinations of atomic orbitals. They may be the SS combination, SP combination, PP combination, PD combination and the DD combinations. Okay, so let us start with the first type of combination. So the first type of combination is the SS type of the combination. So what is the SS type of the combination? When one S orbital undergo overlapping with the another S orbital. So as there are two atomic orbitals, they result in the formation of two molecular orbitals. The two molecular orbitals, they may be bonding and the antibonding. So let us take an example. We are having one s orbital which is having the plus sign. It undergo combination with the another s orbital which is also having the plus sign. So one s orbital undergo combination with the another s orbital as they are having the same sign. So as they are the same sign, they undergo combination and due to which there is a formation of a larger resultant like this. At the center we are having the nucleus and it is having the plus sign. So this results in the formation of the bonding molecular orbital which is called as the sigma. Similarly, there is a formation of the antibonding. So when the antibonding MOs are formed, when the orbitals they are having the opposite sign. So we are having the S orbital which is having a plus sign and another S orbital which is having a minus sign. So as they are having the opposite sign, when they undergo combination, there will be the repulsion, and due to the repulsion, there is a formation of a central plane. That central plane is called as the node. Okay, and across the nodes we are having the opposite side lobes. So one side we are having the plus sign, another side we are having the minus sign, and that is called as the antibonding molecular orbital, and here it is having a symbol sigma asterisk. Okay, so this is called as the SS type of combination. Similarly, we are having the second type of combination. That second type of combination is the SP type of combination. So what is the SP type of the combination? When one S orbital undergo combination with the P orbital, the p atomic orbital. Now we are having the three types of the p orbital. The three types of the p orbitals are the px, py and the pz. For the px orbital, the lobes are pointing along the axis, whereas for the py and the pz, the lobes are pointing perpendicular to the axis. Now in case of the sp combination, we have to consider only that p orbital whose lobes are pointing along the axis. So here we have to get at the combination of the S and the PX. Okay. So again we are having S orbital which is having the plus sign. It undergo combination with the P orbital. Why P orbital? Because its lobes are pointing along the axis. So this is the PX orbital. So when they undergo combination, the plus plus sign, there will be formation of the larger resultant like this. This is the plus sign and the smaller will be for the minus sign. And this is called as the bonding molecular orbital which is having symbol sigma. Okay. Similarly, we are having the antibonding. How the antibonding will be formed? When there is a combination of plus and the minus. So same, we are having the S orbital which is having a plus sign, and then we are having a px orbital. What will the change in the px orbital? Here there will be a minus sign. Here minus and here plus. Okay. So when they undergo combination, so this is s and this is px. When they undergo combination, as they are the opposite sides, due to opposite side there will be repulsion. There will be formation of a central plane. That plane is called as the node, and across the nodes we are having the opposite sides orbital. So one side plus, another side minus. Okay, and this will be somewhat bigger. because it is a repair, and it is called as the antibonding molecule orbital, which is having symbol sigma asterisk. Then let us move to the third type of combination. The third type of combination is the PP type of the combination. What is the PP type of the combination? There is a combination of one p orbital with another p orbital. Again, we are seeing there are three types of p orbital: px, py, and pz. In case of the px orbital, the lobes are pointing along the axis. That means it results in the formation of the sigma bond. And in case of the py and the pz, the lobes are perpendicular to the axis, so it results in the formation of the pi bond. So based upon this, when there is an overlap of the px and the px orbital, it results in the formation of sigma. Whereas when there is a combination of py and py or pz and pz, it results in the formation of the pi bond. So based upon this, we are having the formation of two different types of the MOs. One type of the MO is formation of the sigma MO. One is the sigma MO, another is the pi MO. So let us start with the first one. The first is the formation of sigma MOs. Okay. So how the sigma MOs are formed? When there is a combination of PX and the PX atomic orbital. So when one PX atomic orbital under a combination with the another PX atomic orbital, it results in the formation of the MOs, and that MOs may be the bonding and the antibonding, that is sigma and the sigma asterisk. So let us draw their structures. So we are having one PX orbital. This is suppose first PX orbital. It undergo combination with the second. So for the formation of the bonding, there should be a same sign. So plus and a plus. The resultant. The resultant will be the larger. So plus plus sign, it will be a larger resultant. And to the sides, we are having the smaller, that is the minus. And hence it is called as the bonding molecular orbital, which is having symbol sigma. Similarly, there is a formation of the antibonding. So how the antibonding will be formed? When the opposite sides. So same, we are having one px orbital. It undergo combination with the another px orbital. Now for the formation of the antibonding, there should be the opposite signs. So when these undergo overlapping, there will be formation of a central plane. That central plane is called as a node, and across node there will be the repaired orbital. So repaired orbital will be the plus and the minus. So the structure will be, the repaired orbital will be smaller in structure. So this is plus and this is minus, and its adjacent will be somewhat larger. Like this. This is minus, this is plus, and this is called as the antibonding molecular orbital, which is having symbol sigma asterisk. So this is the formation of sigma MOs. So let us move to the second type, that is the formation of the pi MOs. So when the pi MOs are formed, when there is a combination of either PY, PY or the PZ, PZ. Why this is so? Because the lobes of the PY and the PZ are perpendicular to the axis joining the nuclei, due to which they results in the formation of the pi bond, and hence they results in the formation of the pi MOs. One may be bonding, another may be antibonding. Okay, so let us take an example. Suppose if I am having the PY orbital. Okay, so which is having plus sign, minus sign. This is the PY orbital. One PY orbital undergo combination with the another. For the bonding, what is the condition? The same sign should be nearer to each other. So due to which we are getting the formation of larger resultant. These are the nucleus of the orbitals, and plus plus combination, it will be a larger resultant, like this, and a larger resultant for the minus. Plus plus combination and a minus minus combination, and due to which they are separated by the node, or which is also called as the nodal plane, and hence it is called as the bonding molecular orbital, and here it is called as the pi py. for the p5 orbital it is called as the pi bonding molecular orbital. Similarly, antibonding. So how the antibonding will be formed? We are having the plus and the minus. That is the p-y orbital undergo combination with the another p-y orbital, but it should have the opposite sign. And what happens due to the opposite sign? When they undergo combination, there will be the repulsion, and due to repulsion, there is a formation of the central plane. That central plane is called as the nodal plane or the node. And across that nodes, we are having the repelled orbital. So one side we are having the repelled orbital plus minus, another side the repelled orbitals are the minus and the plus. It is called as antibonding molecular orbital, and here it is the name as pi star is py. Okay, so in this way we are having the formation of the sigma NOs and the pi NOs. So let us move to the four types of combination. So this is the four type of combination, that is the formation of the or the combination of the p and d atomic orbitals. So when one p atomic orbital undergo combination with the d atomic orbital, they give the formation of the p d combination. Now here generally the p y and the p z atomic orbitals overlaps with the d orbital of the other atom to form the pi bond. So we are having the p y orbital. Suppose one is having the plus sign, minus sign, then it undergo combination with the d orbital. The d orbital is suppose d x y orbital. Okay, so for the bonding, the positive positive and the negative negative, they undergo combination. So we are getting the structure as due to plus plus overlap, we are getting a larger plus and a larger minus across the nodal plane, and the remaining as a minus and the plus. This is called as the bonding molecular orbital, and here it is represented as a pi. Whereas how the antibonding will be formed? Again we are having the same, the py orbital and the dxy orbital with the opposite sign. Let us draw the dxy orbital. Now here it is minus, minus, plus and plus. It is called as the dxy. So the opposite sign, they undergo repulsion, and due to repulsion there is a formation of a central plane. That central plane is known as the node or the nodal plane. And across this node we are having the repelled orbital. So the repelled orbitals are the py, which is having a plus, minus sign, and the dxy. The repelled are having the small size, whereas the adjacent will be the larger. This is minus, this one is plus, this is plus, and this is minus. This is a plus one. Okay, so we are having the antibonding molecular orbital, which is having symbol pi asterisk. So this is the combination which is called as the pd combination. Then let us move to the next type, that is the type number 5, which is known as the dd combination. So what is the dd combination? One d orbital of one atom with the d orbital of the other atom undergo combination, that is called as a dd combination, and it results in the formation of the delta NOs. Delta may be bonding and the antibonding. So this formation of delta NOs takes place by the overlap of two dxy or dx square minus y square atomic orbitals. So we are having the structure, suppose we are having the dx square minus y square orbitals. Two dx square minus y square atomic orbitals. So let us draw their structures. These orbitals, they are along the axis. So the axis are x, y and the z. Okay. So suppose if we are having the orbital along the x axis and the y axis, like this. This is plus, plus, minus, minus. Similarly, the second one, x, y and the z along the x-axis, plus minus and along the y-axis, minus minus. Okay, now when they under the combination, what happens? The plus plus under the combination, then minus minus under the combination, again is plus plus under the combination, and the minus minus under the combination. That means we are having the combination of four. Four combinations will be there. So let us see the structure again along the three axis. Suppose this is your x axis, y axis, and the z axis. Now if you see the combination of this plus plus. So what will be the structure? We are getting the larger result front of plus like this. This is for these orbitals, this plus and this plus. Okay. Then this minus and the minus, they are under the combination. So we are getting the structure like this. This is for the minus. Again, this minus and the minus, another side. We are getting the larger result front like this. And then finally, this plus and the plus. Again, we are getting the larger resultant like this. And this type of combination, which results in the formation of the bonding MO, that bonding MO is called as the delta bonding MO. Okay. Similarly, also we can find out the antibonding MO, but that antibonding MO structure is quite complicated. That's why I am not taking that here. Now, let us move to the next. That means along with these various types of combinations, we are also having the non-bonding combinations of orbitals. So what are these non-bonding combinations? Means the orbitals which do not take part in bonding. That's why they are called as the non-bonding. Now why they are not taking part in bonding? Because they are either are very low in energy or they do not have proper symmetry. And hence they results in the formation of the non-bonding molecular orbitals. So let us take examples. Some of the examples are, the first example is when we are having the s orbital, which is having suppose a plus sign, which under the overlapping with a p orbital, the p orbital which may be either the py or the pz. That means again they are of no proper symmetry, and hence it results in the formation of the mo like this. And this is called as the non-bonding molecular orbital. Okay. One more example. We are having the px and the pz or the py. We are having the px orbital and second one is either the py or the pz. Again, they do not have proper symmetry, and it results in the formation of the MOs like this. It is called as the non-bonding MO. One more example. Suppose if I am having a px orbital. This px orbital under the combination with the d orbital. Suppose that d orbital is the dxy orbital, and they under combination which results in the formation of the non-bonding MO. Okay, so in this way we are having the formation of non-bonding MOs. That means the orbitals which do not take part in bonding, they are called as the non-bonding orbitals, and their combination is known as the non-bonding combinations of atomic orbitals. Okay? Thank you.